Star Wars shirt while reviewing a ghost movie. Force ghosts make this appropriate attire, and that is legit-ish. Winchester. So Winchester's a horror movie, a haunting movie, a ghost movie. It's the early 1900s. This doctor, played by Jason Clarke, goes to the Winchester mansion to assess the stability of the Winchester widow who lives there because she says there are ghosts in the house. And this movie's inspired by actual events, I guess. There are actual events tied to this. There is a Winchester mansion. You can go take the tour. You can see it. And this mansion does have over 100 rooms in it. There are staircases and hallways that go absolutely nowhere because supposedly the Winchester widow who lived there felt that adding on to the house would keep the ghosts in check or something like that. That's a story I hear anyway. I didn't do what most reviewers and critics do before filming this, which is go on Wikipedia and act like I know fuck all about the situation. Just telling you what I heard. But the story is, in this house that had 24-hour work happening in it, people heard noises at night. I will say that again. People heard noises at night at a house that had 24/7 construction. Right. But the story there does lend itself to good horror movie content, so now we have one. A horror movie, not a good one though. I mean, I like Jason Clarke. What happened to this guy? Dude was on the climb, man. He was on the rise. Then he did Terminator Genesis, and he climbed a mountain, and now he's in Winchester. I understand, dude's gotta eat. So I imagine this is a job for a paycheck, but he's much better than this movie. However, in this movie, he does bring it. He tries, he gives it his all. Same with Helen Mirren. I feel like the paycheck had to have been big. But as a horror movie, a haunting movie, a ghost movie, this movie just fails because it's so boring. For so long, nothing happens. Then when things do happen, it's all a jump scare. It's always a jump scare. I don't mean it uses jump scares. I don't mean it has jump scares in it. I'm saying every time it attempts to scare you, it is from a jump scare, always. And you can always count it down. You're like, someone's gonna walk by the screen in 3, 2, 1. There's one scene where he's spying on Helen Mirren through this cracked door and you see it from his point of view. I was like, there's gonna be a creepy face just springs right into his line of sight in front of our faces in 3, 2, 1. Oh, look at that, it happened just as it plays out in the horror movie handbook. I'm not saying a movie needs to be original, I'm just saying look like you try. Annabelle 2, Ouija 2, very enjoyable. They didn't do anything groundbreaking, they just did their horror movie job well. This movie didn't even try. I feel like it's a horror movie second, and it does rely on the mythos and the story behind the mansion that we all heard on the school bus, or got popular after social media made it popular. Point is, that's a Wikipedia search right there. Read it online, you don't have to pay $11 to $15 for a movie ticket to have a movie bore you for 2 hours. And this side characters are completely useless. There is a mother-son duo in this movie that I'm like, why are you in it? They used the kid as a plot device a couple times, but it didn't need to happen. Like, if you took him out of the movie, they could have found another way to get to the end game. If you took her out of the movie completely, the movie would not change at all. It does have a reveal or two that I found interesting, or would have found more interesting had the movie been interesting. But in the end, Winchester is just what I don't like about horror movies these days. It thinks the hook of saying inspired by true events isn't enough to sell the movie, and it's not. I wasn't scared, it wasn't intense, I had no anxiety. The jump scares just irritated me. I gauge horror movies by the walk to this room to film videos. It's a hallway, it's nighttime, it's dark. If I walk down there and I feel nothing, movie failed entirely. And Winchester does fail entirely unless you're out of ZQL and you need to go to sleep. Not the worst thing I've seen, I'm just saying I'm not gonna remember Winchester in T-minus one day. Yep, already forgot. All right, so Winchester, have you seen it? What did you think about it? Whatever you thought, comment below, let me know. And as always, if you like what you've seen here and you wanna see more, click right here to see more.